Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Spike's Breezeway Cocktail Hour. We are back for the third cocktail, and we are actually going to be back at the Aku-Aku. If you followed us last week, we made a drink called the Aku-Aku Gold Cup. If you haven't seen it, go back, check it out. Tonight, we're going to make another drink from the Aku-Aku. We're going to make the Lapu, which is a twist on the chief Lapu-Lapu. So for this cocktail, we're going to be using lemon juice, pineapple juice, white grapefruit, orange juice, Falernum from BG Reynolds, Don Q Anejo, gold Puerto Rican rum, Appleton Estate 12 year for the dark Jamaican rum, and Lemon Heart 151 Demerara for the 151 Demerara. So this is an 8 ingredient cocktail. It's supposed to be for 2 people. Before we get into that, I want to show you something that I collected from the Aku-Aku. This is a matchbook from the Stardust and a casino coin from the Aku-Aku. It says, rub my nose for good luck at the Stardust Hotel. And there's the Moai. And in fact, if you know world famous tiki bar builder Bamboo Ben, his grandfather actually built the Aku-Aku. I don't know if he built the Aku-Aku, but at the very least he carved the 2 gigantic Moai. One of them sits out in a park on like an island in the middle of a big bird pond. So that one still exists and it's in Las Vegas and you can go visit it. It's kind of out of the way, but it's kind of like a pilgrimage you have to take, you know what I mean? I think my attraction to the Stardust Aku-Aku is that you know that it was around during the time of the mob and when Vegas was really Vegas, you know what I mean? Not ultra clubs and all that kind of thing. It was like suits and cigarettes. Let's make the drink. All right, we are gonna start off with lemon. I need a knife. We'll need 1 ounce of lemon juice. And lemons kind of have a lot of juice in them, so you can usually get about 1 ounce of lemon juice from 1/2 of a lemon, depending on its size. 1 ounce of pineapple juice. Now, I see a lot of tiki bars using these things, so I think it's more convenient than trying to juice this thing. So, the only thing is you gotta make sure you shake it up. My buddy Kelly Merrill from Trader Sam's, and from also just being my buddy, so stupid. In one of my videos previously, he was like, really, you're not gonna shake up the pineapple juice? I guess it came out all watery. So, see, lesson learned, I'm not a professional. 1 ounce of pineapple juice. 1 ounce of white grapefruit, and I am fortunate that these things grow on a tree right over there, and they hang onto my side of the yard, so I guess we don't have to whisper about it. They're fair game. You always want to use the white grapefruit if you have the option. The other grapefruits are a little too zingy. We'll need to squeeze 1 ounce of grapefruit juice. 1 ounce of Flamingos. Whew, love that smell. It smells like bay rum, like a barbershop, like drinking barbershop stuff. So 1 ounce of Flamingos. The gold Puerto Rican rum that we're gonna be using is this Don Q Anejo. 1 ounce of this. 1 ounce of dark Jamaican rum. Looks like we're getting low on the Appleton Estate here. This is Appleton Estate 12 year. 1 ounce of a 151 Demerara. Now usually these recipes would call for something like pebble ice. This recipe specifically calls for ice cubes. So, we've got some ice cubes here. And it says to mix on high for about 20 seconds, which is fairly atypical of what you would normally do with a tiki drink. Usually it'd be about 4 to 5 seconds. So, I guess they want a lot of water in this. Okay, so that is super frothy, and we're gonna be pouring that into this Orchids of Hawaii tiki bowl. And then it says add more ice cubes to fill this thing. So these are kind of big ice cubes. It probably would look a little bit better if they were smaller, but that's what it tells you to do. So we garnish with a pink gardenia from my neighbor's yard and serve with 2 straws. But it's just me tonight. I've always thought that the saddest thing in the world is seeing somebody on a tandem bike by themselves. Do you know what I mean? Wow, that's really good. There's like layers to the different rums. But I really taste the 151 and the Falernum really coming through. It's really good. So imagine drinking this in 1960 at the retro futuristic atomic themed Stardust Hotel. And I think it's so funny that there's a primitive Polynesian themed place in the casino that was most supposed to be about the future and space travel. That's delicious. And that is the third drink on our list, the Aku-Aku Lapu. So if you enjoyed this, please be sure to comment, like, and subscribe, and we will see you in the next cocktail video. Aloha. Okay.